career accomplishment that's given me the most satisfaction is making a successful transition from a career in academic medicine to one in the business of healthcare. And for me, that's been working within the payer arm of the UPMC Integrated Delivery and Financing System. A lot of the skills that I used during my time in academia are absolutely still relevant and skills that I use every day in my role as Associate Vice President of Population Health at UPMC Health Plan. But the pace at which things move at the health plan and the degree to which I think systems thinking is more important, or at least I guess more relevant to the work that I do, more critical for me to be able to appreciate things from a systems perspective within my role at the health plan that is one part of a larger healthcare system. Those have been some ways that I find my career at the health plan to be pretty markedly different from my career in academia. So it's definitely required some adjustment, some new learning, some new skill building. And I've been fortunate to have a lot of really wonderful mentorship from people at UPMC Health Plan to help me make that transition. And I didn't take it as a given that I'd be able to make the transition. I didn't assume that it would be easy. And there's been a lot of intention put into it, but I'm very proud to say that I've not only successfully made that transition, I've found that attributes of working within the payer environment, I think, are really better suited for my interests, my goals, my temperament, and the things I hope to achieve over the balance of my career. I've been fortunate to have lots of great mentors at UPMC Health Plan. A few that really stand out for me. The first person who was my manager when I joined the health plan, who recruited me to come to the health plan, man by the name of Kim Jacobs, who recently retired from the health plan, but had an incredible career at UPMC Health Plan and was absolutely instrumental in my role at the health plan and in helping me adjust to the environment of the health plan and learn about the things that would best position me for success. And I'd also count my sort of my primary mentor, my postdoctoral mentor from the National Cancer Institute, who's also since retired, Dr. Bradford Hesse, who was my mentor at the National Cancer Institute. But Brad had a career that spanned lots of different environments, including academic environments and industry environments. And so his mentorship has carried through and been incredibly helpful to me within my role at UPMC Health Plan. And then I'll just add that several folks at the health plan, including our CEO, Diane Holder, our Senior Vice President of Clinical and Network, Sandy McAnallen, our Chief Clinical Officer, Deb Wasselcheck, all of these women and so many strong female leaders at the health plan have been instrumental in my making that transition from academia to industry and have just been incredibly supportive and wonderful mentors along the way. And it was, you know, hard initially to not think about answering it very much in the context of my career. But since it was positioned as kind of a broad question, I would have to say my mother. Both of my parents, of course, very influential, but my mother in particular, from a very young age, just really instilled in me some principles that have an impact on everything I do. And, you know, I used the phrase grit and grace in my written answer to this question, which really does a good job of summarizing the guidance that I think my mom has given me in lots of different ways that affect the way I navigate the world broadly and certainly within the context of my career. You know, the importance of working hard, the importance of earning opportunities and not assuming that I'm entitled to any of them. And the importance of having a lot of grace, not only with myself, but with others. All of us are navigating the world together. And I think the more grace that we extend ourselves and each other, the better we're able to support one another and work collaboratively and really connect in authentic ways that I see as the foundation to any meaningful work being accomplished. My career isn't one, and nor did I ever aspire to have a career that would be one characterized by lots of working in isolation or on my own. I've been so fortunate to have the opportunity to work with incredible leaders and teams of people throughout my career. It's the way I prefer to work. And as you navigate all kinds of decisions related to work and trying to solve problems, you know, that collaborative work is so important. And I think it involves a lot of grit and grace along the way. And I really do trace all kinds of lessons related to grit and grace back to my mom, who has navigated the world in her life very successfully, I think, through an excellent combination of grit and grace.